Welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering Lecture Series. Today we're gonna start our chapter number 1, Electrical Safety. And these are our session outlines in which we will try to cover some topics such as Introduction to Electrical Safety, General Safety Rules, Concept of Electrical Shock, Effects of Electrical Shock, and Methods of Removing an Electrocuted Person. Hence, we moved on to the introductory part of this session in which we will see firstly what is safety. As we know, safety is the first provision and the most prior thing while dealing with any of the working field. So, here's the definition of safety, that is the condition of being protected from or unlikely to cause danger, risk or injury. Or we can say safety is the act of protecting ourselves from getting damaged. And second thing is, what is an accident? So an accident is an unpleasant and uncontrolled event which causes or is likely to cause an injury. It is something which is unexpected, unpredictable, unintended or not desired at all. An accident may cause a result of some unsafe activity, act, working condition, etc. So we have to be more safer and safer to prevent ourselves from any of the accident. So here are some causes of accident, that is the accident due to human error. And these are negligence, disregard for safety, unawareness of danger and hurrying. And the accident due to lack of technical knowledge, that is improper use of tool, lack of technical guidance, lack of understanding of proper safety procedure and lack of information about the work. And now we will see some general safety rules. And the first one is, when an electrical circuit is to be overhauled or worked on, switch off the main switch from which supply is fed. Always hang a tag on the switch, that is the work in progress. And second is, all electrical leads should be considered as live until it is positively proved that they are not, and check this with the help of test lamp. Third one is, before starting the work overhead, use rubber gloves, rubber boots, aprons, safety helmets and safety belt wherever required. Why these are rubber boots and rubber gloves? Because these are insulating materials. Now the fourth one is, if the ladder is used, it must be held by another person so that it may not slip away. Fifth, that is, before energizing a circuit, it should be assented that the equipments are properly earthed and the cable insulation is strong enough. There should be proper insulation and the earthing should be proper. Sixth one is, a plug point should never be disconnected by pulling the flexible cable. Seventh, before replacing a blown fuse, always remember to put the switch in off condition. Ninth, while handling a domestic equipment or appliance, be sure that they are disconnected from supply. Switching off is not enough. Leakage current may occur. So we have to first switch off the supply, remove the plug and then operate the equipment. Tenth one is, off the switch while removing the plug from the socket. 11th, do not touch the terminal with bare hands for checking the supply. 12th one is, always use test lamp for testing purpose. Do not use tester. Sometimes it may give shock while it is not operating properly or it is faulty. 13th one is, in case of fire, do not throw water on live conductor or equipment. The best remedy is to disconnect the electrical supply immediately and use dry sand to cover the fire. 14th is, fire extinguishers should not be used on electrical equipments unless it is marked as suitable for that purpose. And the last one is, at least follow the principle, test before touch. Now this is the concept of electrical shock. That is, electrical shock is an skin effect of electric current. As there is magnetic effect, electromagnetic effect, sound effect, light effect of electric current, Similarly, there is the skin effect of electric current. The severity of electrical shock depends upon the following factors, that is voltage level. Higher the voltage level, higher is the value of electrical shock. Type of seasons, that is in wet seasons, you will get the more severe shock as compared to dry seasons. Type of flow, that is severity is more in wet flow, obviously. Fourth one is personality. If you are more fat, you have the more chances to getting a severe shock as compared to a healthy person. Healthy person has the higher body resistance, hence it is more highly prevented from getting a shock. And our next topic is something which is called as the effect of electric shock. We will see it point by point. So the first point is the effect of current at very low levels may only be an unpleasant tingling sensation, but this in itself may be sufficient to cause oneself to lose his or her balance and fall. So at the very low level of current, it may be just experience, but it is more enough to get the person being fall. So the second point is, at higher level of current, the person receiving the shock may be thrown off his feet and will experience severe pain and possibly minor burns at the point of contact. So the third one is, at an excessive level of current flow, the muscles may contract and the person may be unable to release his grip on the conductor. He may lose consciousness and the muscles of the heart may contract spasmodically. This may be very fatal. So at the excessive level of current flow, the person may die. Fourth point is, the electric shock can also cause burning of skin at the point of contact, which is obvious. So our last topic is methods of removing an electrocuted person, which is something very important topic. So the first point is, the severity of electric shock will depend on the level of current which passes through the body, that is the magnitude of current, and the length of current which passes through the body, and the time of the contact, that is for how much time the current is flowing through the body. Do not delay, act at once and make sure that the electric current has been disconnected. So first thing which we have to do is to disconnect the person with the electric current. If the casualty, that is the victim, is still in contact with the supply, follow the given instructions. So these are the methods ultimately. The first is, break the circuit immediately. If the main switch is far away from the victim or there is no information about its placing, cut the live wire with the insulated plier, insulated wire cutter or an axe or any wooden insulating material. So we have to first cut off the main supply. Next is, if it is not possible to break the circuit, separate the victim from the live conductor by a quick motion using non-conductor such as dry rope, a dry coat or a dry stick or any non-insulating material. Do not use anything wet or metallic. It may give you also a severe shock. Next is, be aware of touching the heels or soles of the victim's shoes. Do not touch his body with your hands unless they are covered with rubber gloves, dry clothing or another non-conducting material, that is insulating material. Next and the last point is, after rescuing the victim from shock, loose his or her cloth, apply warm to his body, rub his skin and muscles. So you have to apply warm to the victim after rescuing him. And not feed tea or coffee, any liquid, solid or semi-solid, until he is fully conscious. So do not let him eat or drink anything liquid or semi-solid. It may be fatal to him. So hope you have learned something about the basic concepts of electrical safety. Thanks for watching.